Welcome again. My name is Musashi, and today we're looking at Explosive Reactive Armor, or ERA. It is one of the add-on armor types that you get as modules on some of the vehicles in Armored Warfare. I was quite excited to see mine. I just unlocked my first ERA package on my Bradley. We are still in early access second stage. There are six vehicles currently in EA2. You see them on the screen there, the M60A3, the M2 Bradley, BMP3, B1 Centauro, FV501 Warrior, and the Challenger 1. The M60A3 is the first one we get to see in the game. It's likely the first ERA armor package that everybody got to see, as it is unlocked first, and main battle tanks are quite popular. Nevertheless, it was still very exciting for me to see my first ERA package I would have had access to, which was on my Bradley. It's the Tier 6. Let's take a look at... I actually recorded me putting my ERA package on for the very first time. It's quite expensive, as you can see there. It's 40,000 reputation. And it's 300,000 or 400,000 cash to get it. So I really had to focus on getting that. I decided I wanted to see the ERA package before I cared about upgrading my ammo. Normally, you'd upgrade your offensive power to be able to make more cash and reputation to unlock the other modules. But I was going to head... first, I got the APS system, and I already made a video on that. Now I've got the ERA package, and there you see it's been put on the tank. I already knew it would be modeled on the tank for a couple of reasons, but especially the M60A3 was already in the game with a beautiful-looking ERA package. Here's a turret of the Bradley. This shows you the kind of different shapes. They have names for these different types of ERA explosives that they add to the M1 series, the Bradley series. Large contracts go out to put these explosive reactive armor boxes on the sides of the turret and hull of the various vehicles. The first thing you should know about explosive reactive armor is this stuff is explosive. It really is strapping on high explosives on the side of your vehicle. You know, what it does in terms of trying to defeat heat rounds, an ATGM or a heat round or a shaped charge that's heading for your vehicle, this thing is meant to blow out through the energy of the explosion to prevent that chemical reaction from occurring directly on the face of the armor. Here's a look at the Bradley's sort of different unit modules that they have for ERA. I guess it just seems odd to me because I never had an ERA package on any of the tanks that I crewed in the Army. So I get the reason for it. It looks pretty sexy, and you know, I'd have gladly slapped it on my vehicle had I were given the choice. But the fact that you're just surrounded by high explosives, especially in the Bradley, when you've got dismounted infantry all around the vehicle, that if the thing were to take a shot from an RPG or an ATGM, it's going to cause an explosion. So it might help the guys in the vehicle, but it's not going to help, you know, infantry or what we used to call crunchies right outside the vehicle. So kind of a sort of a mixed feeling about imagining yourself realistically operating around a vehicle that is surrounded by these explosives. Of course, in the Bradley's case, it's meant to carry troops. So you could have, you know, 10, 11 guys piled into this Bradley. So, you know, worrying about dismounts outside of a vehicle is more of a sort of city Fallujah type thing. You know, when you have normal engagement ranges and you're using the vehicle for its true intended purpose, you wouldn't have guys just loitering about on the outside of your vehicle anyway. Here's a look at the actual ERA innards. You've got several layers of high explosive. There's a front facing plate, and then there's a back plate. The whole point of this arrangement is to try to cause the heat round or that chemical reaction to occur prematurely before it starts to interact with the actual armor of the vehicle itself. My interest in looking at the ERA wasn't just to slap it on my Bradley. Since I ran into the M60A3's armor originally, like everyone else did first, it seemed awfully tough. Maybe it's psychologically more daunting looking than it actually was in terms of defeating rounds. But you see here, there's only two main battle tanks in the game currently that have ERA, the M60A3 and the Challenger 1. And this is significant because other vehicles are pretty thin skin that actually have the ERA, the other guys on the list. And just because you have ERA doesn't mean that the ATGM or heat round is not going to go through. It's not an automatic, yeah, I have it, therefore it works. There's still penetration values for the missiles and heat rounds, and the ERA in the game is giving you an assist of X number of millimeters of protection, and that will be reflected in the tooltip in the game. When I was in my BMD-2, I was really interested if my 30 millimeter would be able to detonate the ERA of the M60A3, and I saw it in game a few times, but I could never really kind of get close enough to see how it works. So my main interest with ERA in the game is, can you detonate it and defeat it using 20 millimeter, 25 millimeter, 30 millimeter autocannons? So as soon as I got my ERA package on my Bradley, off I go to test. It's all about you, M60A3. I may have ERA on my Bradley, but I was really curious if can I defeat the M60A3 and other main battle tanks' ERA to soften them up for my missiles in the future. I didn't have access to the M60A3, so I just used the ERA in my Bradley, and we set about testing it with the 30 millimeter, and that's what I'm going to show you here now. So my buddy Shivan is in his BMD-2, and he's going to help me. You see how close he is. He's point blank. And we're counting the number of rounds. He's just aiming on one target, so there's two. At this point, I had no idea whether the 30mm would actually cause an explosion, whether the game was geared to do it. Oh, yep, there, see it is. Yep, it blows it up. So three shots it took. That was an AP round he was shooting. And his AP round was doing about 70, 75 damage, I think was its stated 30mm damage on the AP. But it blows it up, and it seems to blow up a number of the panels, not just one, because there's an explosion that occurs there. So then I wanted to know, okay, so the AP rounds does about 75 damage a shot. What would an HE round do? So there's two, so he shot me twice, three times. We're just counting how many rounds it takes for the HE, and already it's taking more for the HE to blow that panel than the AP round did from the 30mm. There was some confusion because we weren't on comms, we were typing all this in, what kind of ammo he was using, but he was using HE the whole time here. It turns out that it takes between 8 and 10, usually about 10 of his 30mm HE rounds, I think they're HEI actually, but it doesn't matter. It takes about 10 rounds to blow out the panel. But the exciting part is, you can defeat the ERA with autocannons or other ammunition. It clearly just has sort of a hit point value that you have to cross. And based on this initial test, the AP was doing about 75 a round, and it took three shots, maybe sometimes four, and then the HE did, basically it takes about between 150 and 200 hit points before the module will blow. I think it's closer to 200 to be my guess. Now, this is just the Bradley's ERA. It's possible that the M60A3 or higher tiers, even higher than the Bradley, will have more hit points for each ERA box. I kind of doubt that's going to work that way, though, because ERA in the world in real life is all it's very low-tech stuff. It's not that complicated. See, there I'm completely stripped naked now on my vehicle, I mean. This poor guy on my team was wondering what the heck we were doing, because we weren't exactly helping the team win at this stage. So either someone else can test ERA on one of the other five vehicles in the game, or maybe I'll get a chance to do it later and post a video about that too. But I'm almost certain the ERA hit points are going to be static for all vehicles at all tiers. Just my guess. But what I wanted Shivan to do here was to see if where he hit me, if the blowout panels would change. You know, if it was in the center, you'll lose more panels, or if it's on the outside. There is also ERA on the Bradley on the turret and the front, and those modules are the different shapes that I showed you earlier, and I wasn't sure if those smaller pieces would have the same hit points that would require the same amount of damage, roughly 200, to make them blow. We'd also considered, we are very close. I wonder if the distance, you know, a loss for especially the AP, a loss in, that would lose penetration, not damage. So again, the working theory is that it's just a hit point threshold that has to be crossed. So that's why the HE takes so much longer to defeat it. Even though the HE normally has a lot of variables for non-penetration and penetration, and then the numbers are a lot more spread, sort of an RNG thing than the AP does. But we tested this about 10 times total, and it just seems to have about a, you do 200 hit points or thereabouts to each module, and it'll blow. It doesn't seem to matter where that damage comes from or what type of round it is. I only got a chance to test with the 30mm, not with 20 or 25. But again, the working theory here is that it's not going to matter. You see there, he just blew off the ERA panels off my turret, and it took the exact same number of rounds to defeat the turret pieces as it did the side pieces. Which again, when you add it all together, it all points to the ERA is not individually modeled on the tank to have different hit point values. Now I'm in a game with another friend of mine, the Phantom, and we're showing the range that he's going to be shooting his ATGM at me here. And he's very close, and one of the things we wanted to see was, is there an arming range for the missile? See, he hits me, the ERA goes off, but look at the damage I took. So, this is a very good example of that ERA is not an absolute saving grace. It detonated. I got a notification that it was intercepted by ERA, but I still took 400 points of damage. Now, his average on that missile is about 450. So maybe it took some of the damage off, or maybe that's just RNG, or we're not sure. So, okay, let's back up some. So that's what we're doing here. I'm backing up to see if it's going to make a difference in the distance in terms of whether it will still injure me. Another thing we noticed was the APS system, my active protection system, was not going off, even though my teammate was shooting me. And that's for the very sensible reason that if it starts firing at friendly missiles that might be near you, that would be no good, right? So he's about to shoot me again at a farther range on my ERA side here again. And you'll see here, he actually hurts me again. See, he hit me for another 400 damage. So it again told me the ERA reacted. I think it's important to note that again, ERA does not guarantee you're going to defeat a heat or an ATGM round. Here we're just trying, another vehicle. He's in his BMP-2 with a 30mm, and it takes also three shots. It does about the same damage as the BMD-2's cannon. So this was part of the testing I was going to show you just to indicate that it just seems to be a hit point value. It doesn't interact apparently with different calibers, different vehicles. You put enough damage on these panels and they're going to blow. And I just wanted to make sure by hitting the front of the Bradley's ERA package here. Same thing, three shots, blows off. It all works exactly the same way, it seems. Let's take a look at this in slow motion to see again if there is an animation that occurs that's as cool as the APS system was. So it's there, but it's real fast. So I took these still images so we could really see what happens with the animation when the ERA blows. Pretty cool, right? Looks pretty awesome. So the conclusion that I took from this is you not only can strip off the ERA panels from vehicles that have it, but you should do so with the most damaging round you've got. So if you have an autocannon, definitely shoot it with AP instead of HE, because penetration is not an issue, it's just the sheer damage that you do. And three shots per panel from a 30mm cannon is pretty fast, you know, when you consider how many rounds you can actually pepper a main battle tank with. You know, I had previously rarely been shooting AP rounds, especially at the top of a turret of a main battle tank, because you're not gonna penetrate it, so you do very, very little, if any, damage. But now with the stripping of the ERA system, firing AP rounds at main battle tanks that have ERA is extremely viable, if not valuable. It's a tactical thing, though. You know, should you have been spending your time actually trying to hurt him with something that would have taken his hit points down instead of just erasing a part of his armor package? Well, that's for you to decide, but for me, I'm going to be stripping that ERA off of there. Partly because it's fun, and also because I currently have vehicles with missiles, so I need to soften up those panels to be able to have my main armament connect. Hopefully this has been some help to you guys out there. Thank you again for watching Let's Play Armored Warfare. My name is Musashi, and I'll see you on the next episode. Oh, yeah. I see no changes, all I see is racist faces. Misplaced hate makes disgrace to races. We